Montgomery School. Mike's got his own little fan club here. Check that out. Yeah. Awesome. And we got some more over here. Live in Japan. Of course I can't sing, but
you're welcome.
Thank you. Signs are amazing. Thank you so much.
and guitar really are the primary ones that I play kind of okay. And then there are other ones that I did an album a couple years ago called Monker Tom, and I played all the instruments on it, which means drums and bass and violin and saxophone and a bunch of stuff that I can't play particularly well, but played well enough to get something on tape that I enjoyed listening to. Yeah. I have never actually lived in Japan, but I've visited Japan quite a bit, and it is a very nice place.
That's a segue, I think.
Well, are the fifth graders here yet?
No, but if you want to do it twice again, I'll
Well, it's so hard to sing that if I try to do it
Okay, put it off then.
You know, let's be showbiz about this. We'll hold on to the hit.
Sure. Okay.
Yeah? Scotty. Hi,
I'm Scotty.
I know you are. It doesn't even necessarily have, he's asking how you write a song. Sometimes you sit down and you say, okay, I'm going to write a song, but other times music just pops into your head. What I usually try to do in those situations when a piece of music just pops into my head is just relax and wait for the next piece of the song to come. And usually if I stay out of my own way and I don't tell myself, oh, I can't do this or it's too hard, if I just say, okay, the music will come if I let it come, then slowly but surely a whole song just appears. And you know, my feeling is that the music exists outside of me and it just sort of comes through.
Hi, my
name's
Jennifer, and I was wondering
what influenced you to write Little Japan? Actually, strangely enough, it was an album, I don't know if you've ever heard of a group called Chicago, but they did a concert album called Live in Japan, and I just saw it on the album cover, and I thought, well, wouldn't it be funny to do a song that's called Live in Japan, but it looks like Live in Japan, and somebody might think that it's a live recording or something, but it's not. So it was that, it was just like a silly pun, but you know, when I got more into it, I was thinking about somebody who you know was interested in making a change, and their way of demonstrating that is to move to a new place, then Live in Japan became like a nice metaphor for that. Let's go with this. Come on.
What kind of music do I play?
Well, it's basically rock, but it's I love a lot of different kinds of music. I really like jazz. Like Miles Davis and John Coltrane are two of my favorite people in the world. I love modern composition. I love when people improvise, which is just when you know people just start playing music together without any idea of what exactly they're going to play, but they communicate with each other. It's like having a conversation with you. I love that kind of stuff. And I mix it all together in the music that I do. Yes, sir.
My name is Zach Eden.
Hello.
How long have you been professional?
In terms of like, you know, actually going out and making money and people seeing me and stuff like that? That when I played with this guy, Frank Zappa, in 1987 is when I joined his band, that's the first time anybody actually put me out on a stage in front of thousands of people. Wow, there's thousands of people out there. And then through the 90s, I played with other guys. There's a guitar player named Steve Vai, who's real popular, and I play in his band too. So it's been about 14 years now that I've been in this professional. Someone who hasn't picked you. Well, you're Scotty again, aren't you? Hi. What kind of modern music do I like? My favorite band is Radiohead. In fact, they just put out a CD today, and I actually stopped at the Best Buy on the way here to buy it. Yes, far on the left, looking in the wrong direction. I'll go somewhere else.
Yeah.
Scotty, you got another question?
Thank you. Yeah. What's your favorite Canadian song? What's your favorite?
The biggest audience I ever played in front of was about 60,000 people. That was at a bull ring in Spain. And my favorite instrument to play is the drum, but I really love the piano too.
Yeah.
She was asking if I've played in a lot of different parts of the world. Yeah. I haven't really counted how many countries or anything, but barely know English. I don't know any other languages besides English.
Yeah.
How many concerts have I what? How many concerts have I done? I've lost count. It's probably somewhere, you know, getting close to 1,000 at this point, because I started doing them in the late 80s, and I do a lot of shows every year.
What?
My favorite song is actually, there's a song by a guy named Donald Fagen, and the name of the song is Maxine, and I can't play it for you. Oh, that I wrote? My own favorite song, wow. You know what, I've never thought about that before. That's a really interesting question. Let me think on that, and I'll see if I can come up with that during the thing. Hi, well, maybe I should just go ahead and do the song. It looks like that. So this is Living the Camp, and I've been doing shows every night, and usually I'm not singing this early in the day, so I might have trouble hitting some of the notes. So if you guys could help me go, Live in Japan, that would be great. I have a feeling I'm not going to have too much problem with that, so here we go.
Yeah.
Did I play potato? Yeah. How long did it take to write this song? Well, it sat around for a while. I wrote just the very first part of the chorus, part that goes, "Live in Japan." That little melody and the words "Live in Japan," those came to me right away, and then sat around for about a year before I wrote any of the rest of the song. But I just knew I wanted to write kind of a happy song that was based on that. And then the whole rest of it probably took about 2 days to come once it finally did. Pretty much, I write all my songs. I mean, when I play live, sometimes I'll play other people's music, but it's just for fun. And when I do albums, it's usually all my own songs. How do you go about writing a guitar part? Well, usually I get like a little piece of music in my head, like some idea for something, and then I figure out a way to play it on a guitar that's fun. Like, somebody sing a little melody. Somebody just come up with like three notes. Yeah, you. Yeah, just sing a melody. Okay, you got one. No, you know what inspired me? And I saw a Cranberries commercial. You know the group of Cranberries? You ever hear of them?
Yeah,
I saw a commercial for one of their albums, and the Oasis video of Champagne Supernova. Those two things, for some reason, made me think of the song Potato. Inspiration is where it doesn't really make logical sense. Hi. Yeah. Well. Well, He's probably the famousest. Yeah.
I met Britney Spears.
What's that?
I met Britney Spears.
You met Britney Spears? Was she cool? Was she nice to you?
Good.
What's that?
Yeah.
I wrote the song very quickly, and the line after that, it says, Briggs' charts flew away in a tornado. The guy who was playing drums with us at the time, Frank Briggs, we were playing outdoors, and this big wind flew up and blew his music away, and he had to stop playing in the middle of the song and just sit there and look at the rest of the band. Yeah.
When did I meet you?
Oh, Mr. B. I thought you said Mr. Big. You wrote me a letter in 1994 or something.
Yeah, it was the Z Show. It was the Z Show in Philly in 94.
Yeah, but you had actually written to me before then.
Yeah.
Yeah, he'd gotten in touch through the mail because he liked the music, and we corresponded that way, and then we finally met when I was playing with a group called Z. And he usually comes to the shows when we play in Philadelphia, and I'm always really happy to see him. He's a cool guy. Where did that go? It just shows she's got a main fixation.
I used to live off
Farmington. Okay. It was the university in Farmington in Maine. We did a show there. Hi.
Can you play a song before you were in the
band? I'm sorry, what did you say? Everybody
asked for 5%.
Ryan, do you know what he said?
I don't know. Drew, what do you say? He wants to know if you'll play a Z song.
A Z song? No. I'm not. Are you a Z fan? Okay. Nothing springs to mind. I apologize. I can't remember any of the songs that I played. I don't know if you know who Z are. They were a band that was led by Frank Zappa has two sons named Dweezil and Amit, and they had a group called Z. You. Have any other songs? Yeah, I've got tons. I'll play some. Yeah. You ask your question. All right. Hi.
How many albums do you have?
I've done 9 albums now. That's 9 of my own albums, but I've played on about 60 other albums.
What
other people? Frank Zappa, Steve Vai, Z, Screaming Jay Hawkins. I'm trying to think of anybody you might have heard of, but they're probably not.
Okay.
Yes.
I had a question. When you go and play, what's your favorite cover to play?
What's the one? I'm sorry.
Favorite cover to play?
My favorite cover
play
song.
Play someone
song?
Else's music.
Yeah, I love playing songs by Radiohead. There's a song called the Karma Police by Radiohead that I really love to play. What you want to hear? I think it's okay. We can play that.
Sure.
Okay. Well, we'll find out later if there's one.
Thank you.
And our friends are all of Yeah, okay, now just make a bunch of weird noises.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. I really appreciate this.